Hello everybody, I'm going to be showing you how to do a Haruka Nanase cosplay because I recently finished my maid version of him and I thought I would show you how to do his normal version. To start off, you're going to want to wipe your face off some just with a wet washcloth or so. Then once you do that, you're going to want to put on some foundation. I have CoverGirl, it's in ivory, and I just use it to lighten up my skin tone and smooth it out some. If your hair gets in your way like mine does, you can just pull it back with your wig cap real quick, so. Mighty fall in love. To do your eyebrows, I smooth mine down with just a glue stick. And then I cover them with more foundation to kind of make them disappear so they're not as prominent. If you don't have dark eyebrows, you might not have to worry about them. At this point, I do his eyeliner. You're not going to want to give yourself any dramatic wings or anything super thick and feminine. But what I do is I make the edge of my eye more angular, like I go up and out a bit. I'll show you once I do it. I will put a picture of the finished product like right here so you can see how it is because the laptop camera doesn't zoom in on it well. From there, I do the mascara. I only do a little bit on the top lashes, not on the bottom, because you don't want to frame your eyes too much. That makes you look more feminine. Chemistry, DNA, make me wanna give you every dollar out my B of A. Like, I let her climb on top. I'm either fucking or working. While you have your mascara out, you can go ahead and do your eyebrows. Or you can use eyeshadow for this as well, but I prefer mascara because it looks a little more natural. And what I do is I follow the natural arch of my eyebrow up and around, but I do it more thin. Depending on how your eyebrows are shaped, you might not be able to follow a natural arch, so you'd have to create it on your own. At this point, if you need to, you can add some shading to make your face look more angular. If you do the shading, you'll want to do some up here at your temples, just a little bit. Follow your cheekbone down, and a little bit on the edge of your jaw. From here, if you want, you can use a nude lip balm like I do and just go over your lips because pink lips are more girly and this will add to your masculine effect. Lastly for me, I add some baby powder over top of it to help set the makeup, and it's especially helpful if you're going to a convention. It won't wipe off as easily, especially if you start to sweat if it's in the summer. Only do a little bit. Try not to get it in your eyelashes or on your eyebrows. And now I do the wig. I have two wigs that I use. I have this one which is wavier and darker than my other one. I like it because it adds more texture to his hair so it doesn't just lay flat. The other one works as well, it's just longer and a little harder for me to style. You'll see me use it in a lot of pictures though. After I comb this wig down, I make sure all the hair is untucked. I like to kind of mess with it a little bit with my hands before I actually style the bangs, like I said, to give it more texture so it looks more realistic, not just like it's lying flat on your head. For Haru, he has kind of stereotypical anime boy hair, and he just has it flat at the sides and then a piece in the middle. Like I said, I alternate between this wig and another one that's longer and more straight. I find that either one works for him depending on what style I'm going for. The laptop camera that I'm using kind of flips my picture, so their bangs are actually supposed to be moving the other direction. I don't think I can do that with this wig, but just keep that in mind. You can probably see me struggling. For his jacket, I just have the Iwatobi one. I have a sports bra on now, and when I take pictures, I just move the straps down and try to take pictures far enough up that it looks like I'm shirtless. I will include a tutorial in the description on how to do the taping to move your breast up and over, so when you wear a jacket it looks like you're shirtless completely. I've never done that myself yet, so I'm not going to do it here, but I will include that. I do want to include, if you really wanted to, you could do some shading on your collarbones here. I know lots of people do the makeup to make it look like they have abs. I haven't attempted either of those yet, but if I do, I'll include a tutorial on it. It's important when posing as a male character, if you're female, to keep your shoulders more broad and kind of stiff. Don't do it too much, you don't want to look like you're posing, but they do not have as slanted shoulders as females, so I just kind of like roll mine back and I open up the jacket more. Finding the right angle if you're like taking pictures of your head so that it looks like your jaw is stronger helps a lot too. And that's how I do my Haruka Nanase cosplay. I will include some pictures that I've taken here. Both of with this wig and with my other wig, so you can see the comparison. I kind of prefer the other one, but this is the only one I had right now because that one's dirty. Hopefully you'll check out our other videos as well. We'll be remaking some of our old tutorials. I'm going to murder my birds because they haven't stopped doing that since I started filming. We'll be remaking some of our other tutorials as we improve the cosplays. We will hopefully start making CMVs soon. We really want to get a better camera than what we have, and we'll try and keep you guys updated on our Facebook page on our upcoming cosplays and progress with those. So I hope you enjoyed. Stay awesome.